And when you hunt, you don't eat from the forest. You bring back home. Point. Do you know what is killing Africa? People come to Africa, work here, and take back to their homes. Come collect our resources, take back to their homes. And that's how they're developing. You're earning from the first world country, invest in the third world country, and live there. That is when we are going to grow and boom, we are going to take the world by surprise. Some of the reasons given as to why, or as a way forward on how Africa can move forward or how Africa can be developed, is Africans in diaspora coming back to Africa. I know they have a part to play, but I can't stop emphasizing that Africans living in Africa have a responsibility to play. Our own responsibility is not only to lament or grieve about what the state of Africa is, the leaders and all that. Let's all collectively do our roles. My name is Erina TL and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Please, if you're not yet part of the family, consider subscribing, because we are going to share a lot. You are going to see a lot that comes out of Africa and you're going to enjoy and place that. So, one of the content creators, Amito Mitra, came out with a video. How can the Africans in the diaspora develop Africa? That is what we are going to be reacting to. We are going to be discussing that. Feel free to share your different opinions. And please remember, comment section is where various people come to collect ideas and opinions. Let me tell you, some of our leaders are watching our videos. So feel free to share your opinion in the comment section below. Do not shy away from that. Skylanta Uganda. Skylanta Uganda is a content creator right on YouTube. You can check them out. This is what they have to say. I have been encouraging my family members abroad to think of investing home, because think about it, if imagine every family member in the diaspora had a manageable business back home, that would be a good fallback. I agree with Skylanta. Let's not just make money and still leave it in those other countries. If we could be out there, I know we're out there making ends meet, working hard and all that. If we could get and invest back home, we are providing, first of all, jobs to other people. We are bettering our communities and we are making a change. Because to change Africa, we are not going to just change a continent. It is going to start with a small home, which is going to impact a community. A community will impact probably a town, a district, or a society, and then a country, and then Africa at large. That is how the chain goes. I agree with Skylanta. There is this comment that got my attention so much. So much. And let's see this. Amito, because this is John Moore Yokana reacting to Amito's video, says, Amito, there are also Africans in the diaspora like me who are descendants of the Atlantic slave trade, scattered on tiny islands in the West Indies, and were completely cut off from the continent. No languages, no history, no names, no heritage, no knowledge, but we too are waking up and discovering about the motherland. The major criticism often heard is that African governors are corrupt and allow our resources to be taken away by oppressors who have been raping the continent of its natural resources for centuries to enrich themselves. Enrich themselves while leaving Africa in its own broken state. The hour has come for Africans everywhere to focus on rebuilding the continent by investing in infrastructure, in agriculture, in industries, factories, which will create employment, retain the resources at home for other projects. This is a great point. The Chinese, Syrians, etc. are doing it. So Africans everywhere should be doing the same instead of mourning about the terrible conditions of Africa. I really, really wholeheartedly agree with what John said. Instead of mourning about the condition in Africa, about the government, actually it is us. Do you realize those leaders are elected by us? Yeah, so the more we lament about, I think we should take an initiative and vote right. Africa is where people are bribed with sugar and rice to vote a person, not depending on their credibility. So John, I really agree with you. First of all, let's vote right. Next, Let's invest home. I like what one of the content creators said. The only way Africa is going to gain wealth, that is in relation to our people working abroad, is working, earning from USA while investing in Africa. That means earning from a first world country and investing in a third world country. That is what our brothers in the diaspora should look at. You're earning from the first world country, invest in a third world country and live there. That is when we are going to grow and boom, we are going to take the world by surprise. I hope my point is made clear. So if the brothers abroad could invest in agriculture, Enkumbi Terimba, we have that saying in Uganda that our whore never lies. He who uses it very well doesn't. Actually, this one was trying to mean that agriculture will never let you down. We can feed the entire world as Africans. So my brothers in diaspora, feel comfortable to invest home. To invest home. And don't forget to share your opinions in the comment section below, because we are learning from each other. I think we've had opinions of some of the people in the diaspora. My other opinion is what I've briefly talked about. Investing is one thing in the different sectors, but mainly I would encourage agriculture because it's the backbone of Africa. So that is one thing, investment. I'm from a first class country, invest in a third world country, because that's what most of African countries are. So another point is coming back and sharing the knowledge with the people at home. I slightly highlighted this, but it is very important. We can't underestimate the power of a strong mind, the power of knowledge, and the power of understanding. So if we could have our brothers and sisters come back home, share the knowledge of what they have learned from that side. Share with others, teach others, practice. That would help us. It would basically challenge us and wake us up to what other countries are up to. But every time you stay in Kampala and then you think, oh, because you've moved to your village to Kampala, the capital city of Uganda, you think it's the best in the whole world because you've not moved around. But if you have someone tell you about what is happening in New York, what is happening in other cities around the world, it could probably challenge you and you work towards your country moving in that same direction. That's why I have discovered the beauty in travel. Ever since I traveled to Rwanda and saw the cleanliness in Rwanda, I have never littered a thing in my Kampala. I've never littered a, is it called littered? Littered. Oh yes, English, don't betray me. I've never littered a thing in Kampala because Rwanda is so clean. Like clean is clean as the word clean is. That is how clean. How about if someone shared with us how things are done somewhere else? You get? So me, I am privileged. I travel, and when I travel, I come back, I share what I have seen, I share what I have learned, I share all the knowledge I've collected from my various trips with the people around here. How about when our brothers who are wherever they are, when they come back, even if it's for a visit, for a break, feel free to invite 3 or 4 youth, talk to them, tell them how things are done. If you see someone doing wrong, or they have misconceptions about the various things happening around or stuff like that, talk to them, show them a different view of how things are done, correct them immediately using the knowledge and your experience or your exposure from other developed countries. I think that can also help Africa. I have never had anyone come back to Africa and probably they are sharing knowledge. All we keep saying, Africa, we are behind you, we are behind you. We are. They are those people are far. Those people are far. We can never get them. Oh, they are developed. How are we going to develop Africa? If we are just going to sing how behind we are, and we are not going to implement a little of the things we've seen elsewhere, the things that are helping them excel and shine out, then how are we going to support the motherland? No way. All we have to do is let's teach or inspire or challenge those at home. Let them also get to see things in a different lens. I tell you, there are people who have never traveled out of their villages. And even when they come to Kampala, they think, oh, it is a city, it is the best in the world. You've not seen what is in Kigali. You've not seen what is in New York. You've not seen in what is in Lagos or stuff like that. So if we could please share what we have seen, challenge ourselves with other people's progress, then we can move forward. Because a challenge changes the mindset. And let me tell you, once our mindset is changed, we are set ablaze for better things. These are my opinions on how best we can develop, on how best the Africans in the diaspora can help in the development of Africa. We can all agree to the fact that a lot of Africans are flying out to try and search for greener pastures. Some are in the United Arab Emirates, in the US, in Canada. Like, Africans are all over the world, out of Africa. They are in China. They are everywhere else, trying to make ends meet, trying to work so hard. But let me tell you, we are not going to make it if people are just going to fly out, work, and stay there. We are missing out a point. We are missing out a point. Do you know what is killing Africa? People come to Africa, work here, and take back to their homes. Come collect our resources, take back to their homes. And that's how they are developing. Why not us go work and bring for Africa? Why? Because you people out there in the diaspora, you are like hunters. And when you hunt, you don't eat from the forest. You bring back home. So let's do the same. As other people are coming and working here and taking back to their homes, they are leaving Africa with nothing. Let us also go hunt and bring home. Hunt and bring home. This is how best we are going to grow and develop. This is, Ugandans are flying out, Kenyans, Rwandans, everywhere else, Nigerians, the whole of Africa, every country has this issue going on. And some of them, the conditions they are working in, they can't allow you to stay there over 10 years. So why not hunt and bring home? Yes. What we've been calling the exploitation of Africa is people coming here, working here in the name of helping Africa, and at the end of the day, they take whatever they have collected to their homes, and they have developed, they have grown. Can't we do the same? Can't we learn from them? I really think we can do this, and I'm hoping we can learn. Meanwhile, as we continue devising means on how Africans in the diaspora can grow and develop Africa, I still emphasize, let the Africans in Africa, all people who are home, also take responsibility. Let's do all we can. Let's support those who are away, because as they are making their investments here, let's be trustworthy and run all things well. Otherwise, what is it going to benefit if whatever they are working for and sending back home is misused? Eventually, someone loses morale and they're like, what the hell am I working for? And they choose to stay that side. Please, let's be diligent, let's be trustworthy, and let's work together, all for the good of Africa. And thank you so much, Amito Mitra, for sharing your views on this. Thank you so much for collecting and gathering your friends share their views on this. I appreciate you so much. And I appreciate all the content creators that are working so hard to share various opinions on how best we can grow our motherland. I do not take you for granted at all. Thank you for watching. It's been your girl, Erina TL. And please feel free to subscribe to the channel and tell a friend to tell another friend to tell another friend to check out Erina TL.